So we're just making some pens here now. Well, we're gonna make another windbreak here. Just put the heat on and got the furnace going too, so should be warm in here before we know it. Anyway, I got the one leg welded on, or tacked on, I guess I should say. It's hanging up from the somebody wants to send me a message on Instagram. Anyway, so we're just making another windbreak. I gotta make another windbreak. I got one frame out back yet. I gotta throw some boards in it. I'll get the kids to help me take some nails out. We're gonna reuse some of the boards from the old corral that we used to have. It used to be right over there where that windbreak is, where my cows are up over by the barn. Over there. So anyways, I took all that down last summer because it was falling down. I guess it's been up for 12 years now, so that's quite a while, I guess. So we're going to turn these into, like I said, windbreaks. I got a frame out back. I got to put boards in. I got to take the nails out of the boards. They're sitting out in the backyard, in the bin yard. And then we'll just slide them in. I'm gonna make another one like that and see how it goes. And this time I'm going to drop the boards in here. I'm gonna put the board across here and screw them, and that will hold the boards apart, so that way I don't need the boards to be real tight in here so they don't flop and fart around that way. So anyway, that's what we're gonna do. I got this one tacked on right there, and I'm gonna weld it up. And then I'm going to set the other welder up. Weld right there is the other leg. So that's gonna go on. And then gonna go up back with the tractor and get me, what do I need? Four sucker rod. And then I'll get the rails and weld that 1-inch flat bar on the bottom to hold the bottom of the boards in. And yeah. Basically, I'm just building a video because I hadn't made one here for a few days, so that's all that I'm just going on. I got one cow to calve yet. Excuse me. One cow to calve and we're done calving, so anyway, I guess we'll leave you here for now. I'm going to get to work on this here in a quick minute, so I'll see you in a bit. Alright guys, so got the legs all on. Weld it up good enough. Now, next we're gonna, I cleaned all this shit out of here. That's be good enough. I'll just turn the gas up a little bit. Same as here. Look at the rust on these pipes. It's just fucking horrendous. So we'll get these welded up and then they'll look like this side. Down here. And yeah, so good thing about squishing them is I break all that rust off when it squishes. So that's kind of nice, gets a little better weld, but anyways, as you just take, here's my trick. I take this, and I just go in here like this. See how that comes off of there? If I wasn't using my left hand, like that. But anyways, that's all I do, just around the weld. And as it heats it up, the rest of the shit will peel off too, so. Anyways, that's my little trick. Get a good weld down there. When I do that, I just hit it with a hammer and most of it falls off. So yeah, that's about it, I guess. I'm gonna get these welded up here now. I got them all cleaned up, so anyways, here's my settings, what I use. About 375 inch per minute and about 21 volts. Sometimes it go a little higher depending on the rust. Leave the wire speed a little slower, then the gas can burn right in there and burn that shit out. So anyways, I'll get these welded up and I'll bring you back. Okay, guys. I got the top welded and the bottoms now. Everything's done. Here, this one's done. That one's done. So now I got to usually what I used to do before is I used to flip these. I'd make the main frame. Okay, main frame. I weld it one side, flip it over, weld the other side, then flip it back up and put the legs on. But I kind of skipped a step now. I guess you just learn these little things as you go. A little bit quicker stuff here and there, but yeah. So anyways, now we're gonna get, I'll show you here. Gotta take my little pieces of sucker rod like this, what I got a bunch cut. Well, not a bunch, I don't have enough here, but anyways. Jeepers, come on, finger. Work with me. Generally, I got two pieces cut like that. Well, I actually got more than that, but anyways. So what I do is I go halfway down and I weld these babies on like this. Two, and that'll give me the space for the boards. Inch and a half. This is 3/4 inch sucker rod, so that'll be plenty enough for the boards. And same as up here, I weld these on this way, like this. And then I run the sucker rod across. You guys, if you have missed anything, you can go watch the actual video of me building these ones. So anyway, I gotta find some more little pieces of sucker rod and cut them up, and I'll bring you back in a bit here. Okay guys, we got top pieces are all welded on now. We gotta weld the bottom strip on, and then two strips down each end, down there. Two strips just like this, but long ones. So same here, these are on there. Those guys there. So that'll be that top rod goes on, and I'll just get welded to the, what do you call, I guess the face. Face of here, so that'll get welded onto there, and them two. And then there'll be one that goes across here, all across the front. But I gotta cut two that go in here. So I'm gonna have to get about five rods, and then put along the bottom two, and then that lip. So just about done. Anyway, I gotta take this out and go and grab some sucker rod. Okay, boys. Well, just about got her done here. Excuse me. Anyways, I got all these on now. She's all coming together. There she is. Oh yeah, very good. So now, like I say, all the boards go in here. If you guys want to see this whole video, go watch the one with plankless boards or whatever the heck it was, windbreak something anyway. Anyways, all I gotta do yet is put the sucker rod on the bottom and then that 1-inch flat bar. So you guys want to watch it, go ahead and watch it. I think I'm just gonna leave this here and add on something else. Maybe I'll go do a calf check and goat check or whatever. Kids, we only got, like I say, one more cow to calve yet, so she might be here in the next day or two, I'm thinking. But yeah, I don't know. I should make one of these for old South Sass Farmer there on the YouTubes. I'm sure his livestock will appreciate a little windbreak. Should be good for his chickens. So, anyway, I guess it should be good enough. So, that being said, I guess I'll leave you there. Like I said, I'm gonna, I gotta clean a bit up there on the bottom bar yet, and I got two more sucker rod to put on, and then a 1-inch flat bar that goes on the bottom just to hold the boards in. And yeah, that's good enough. So might as well tell you what I'm gonna do. Like I said, if you want to watch it, I don't even know how to put links in here, so you'll just have to go and look through and see what you can find. There's one in there, I can't remember what the hell it's called, something windbreak anyways. But there she be. So I'll leave you here for now, and I gotta go check cows here pretty soon anyway, so maybe I'll get some footage of that to end the video. So good enough. We'll see you in a bit. All right. So we got to take some water. We got to go over to the open cows that are way over in the far pen at the squeeze chute. Anyway, I figured we might as well make some rounds here. Show you everybody. Okay, are you going in there? Nope, he's mad. Summer broke his freaking plane.
It was an accident.
Oh, okay. Anyway, this little, what's this one's name again?
Blueberry.
Blueberry, that's the kid yet. Those are the little kids.
The tiny ones.
And the tiny ones, yeah. So anyway, we got a little heat house there. There's a cord goes to it. There's a heat lamp inside of there. And then they got a creep area where they get creep feed and get away from the mothers. So that's the goat. So there's one left to kid, like I said. How are you now, Kirby? You guys have to water these guys after, hey? There's the three bucks. Fucking stooges. There's Brian! How are you going, Brian? Anyway, here's your cow, Andy. 30F. She's already had her calf. Where is it now? Here's Brutus. Brutus, you big bugger. Look at him. He's 2 months old. Here's these other little guys. And there's Brutus. So this is the mums and babies pen. There's a bunch in here. Little calves. I haven't figured out which ones we're gonna sell yet. We got two heifers we gotta sell, so. Hey? You maybe? We'll see. Some two people have spoken for some heifer calves after they're weaned. So in there, if you guys can hear or not, the freaking wind's terrible. The little black pail, I got diatomaceous earth in there, and the calves love it. They look like they got a cocaine addiction. Anyway, make our way over to here. Here's the bulls. Hey, he's mad. He can't get a drink. I mean, grain. Oh well. Pretty soon, I want to make those windbreaks. I'm going to put them out there. You guys can see that feed bunk out there. Here's the alley that goes out to that north pasture. So that's where they're going to be going here pretty soon. Anyway, I'll keep going over here. We got, what, 6 pairs in here, I think. One in the barn. One in there, she's smart, she gets out of the wind. That one's calved, that's the only one that we got left that's in the shed. So all these other guys have already calved already. Maybe we'll sneak in there. Maybe we'll sneak in there real quick. See if she had her calf or what the heck. Hey, Seven, how you doing? You have your calf yet? Hey, it's out of poop anyways. She's quite loose on the back. Yeah, I'm gonna have to keep an eye on her. She might calve yet tonight. Upside down fork, that's handy for them to step on. There, we'll leave it on that side. Hey, mama, how you been? Come here, come here. You can go out there if you want. There you go. How's that? There are little calves everywhere. So the water that we're filling right now needs to go to that far pen. That's where we put some open, well, not open, but ones that we didn't want bred yet. Ones that we estimated to stop the pregnancy, but So we got a few over here. These ones either were open or lost their calf. So, or haven't ever been bred. I got that little black heifer we just bought. Right there. And Rosie. There she is. Rosie! Can you see her tag? She'd stand still. And there's that little heifer right there that we bought or just got from Woolbars. There's Rosie! Even had her name tag. So anyway, these are all open here, so those ones are gonna be bred and set up to be bred. It's a nice old cow, but anyway, so that's the tour. What are you guys doing? Your tongue is out. What are you doing? Man, go get him. Go get him. Anyway, where's your little guy? Yeah, he's over there. No, he's right there. That's three. He's over there. Yeah, that's not yours. 16. Where's your little black guy? Probably over there with that one. But anyways, guys, kind of just a little update. Happy Easter deal. Just got to wait for that trough to fill, and then that's what I said. Wait for that trough to fill, and then I'm gonna bring that over here, do the water, and then head her in for the night, I guess. Have to get up probably in the middle of the night and check that number five. It's our last one. She decided to come out of the shed now, so anyways. Alrighty. Well, I guess I'll leave you here for now. Man, it's slippery out here. What can I tell you? We got some news, I guess. Hopefully. Well, it's not real good news, but we're hoping hoping next week here, or this week coming up, probably like I would say maybe Friday. We're going to try combining our flax, so maybe tomorrow I can rip up to the city. My truck is supposed to be done tomorrow with the new springs, the old 7-tree, but yeah, anyway guys, I'll leave you with that, and hey, hold on for a second here, look at this little guy. See their white faces like that? That's from that diatomaceous earth. Like been snorting. But anyway guys, thanks for watching. Give us a thumbs up, leave a good comment, rate and subscribe. So we will see you in the next one. Talk to you later.